Declare this day, amen, that they have been called by God into this office, and we are here to affirm this, amen, that the church signify once again by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen. Come, let us worship God. There are different gifts.
But in the same Spirit who gives them.
There are different ways of serving God.
But it's the same God who is served.
Each one is given a gift by the same Spirit.
To use for the common good.
Together we are the body of Christ.
And individually members with one another.
Amen, amen. God bless you. We're going to have our reading, amen, service in the Word, the Old Testament scripture reading. The law will be read by Pastor Gertrude Jagai. The prophets will be read by Pastor Helen Dukes. The psalms will be read by Apostle Priscilla McCray. The New Testament scripture reading, the epistles by Prophetess Pamela King, the epistles by Prophetess Marshall Davis, the gospel by Pastor Leon Davis.
That I saw the Lord. He was seated on a lofty throne and trained a throne to build a temple. Attending him were mighty seraphims, each having 6 wings. With 2 wings they cover their faces, with 2 they cover their feet, and with 2 they flew. They were calling out to each other, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of heaven above, of our armies. The whole earth is filled with his glory." Their voices shook the temple to its foundation. And in that building was filled with smoke. Then I said, "It's all over. I'm doomed. For I am a sinful man. I have filthy lips. And I live among people with filthy lips. Yet I've seen the King, the Lord Heaven's army." Then one of the seraphim flew to me with a burning coal. He had taken from the altar with a bare tongue. He took his lips, touched my lips with it and said, "See, this coal was touched your lips. Now your guilt is removed and your sins are forgiven." Then I heard the Lord asking, "Whom shall I send as a messenger to this people? Who will go for us?" I said, "Here I am, send me." May the Lord have a blessing to the reading and the hearing of the
word.
Amen. Amen. I will be reading for you from Psalms, biblical Psalms, chapter 16, verses 1 through 11. "Keep me safe, O God, for I have come to you for refuge. I said to the Lord, 'You are my master. Every good thing I have comes from you. The godly people in the land are my true heroes. I take pleasure in them. Troubles multiply for those who chase after other gods. I will not take part in their sacrifices of blood or even speak the name of their gods. Lord, you alone are my inheritance, my cup of blessing. You guard all that is mine. The land you have given me is a pleasant land. What a wonderful inheritance. I will bless the Lord who guides me. Even at night, my heart instructs me. I know the Lord is always with me. I will not be shaken. For he is right beside me. No wonder my heart is glad and I rejoice. My body rests in safety. For you will not leave my soul among the dead or allow your Holy One to rot in the grave. You will show me the way of life, granting me the joy of your presence and the pleasure of living with you forever." May the Lord bless the hearing of this word.
Amen.
Bless you. I am reading from Ephesians, the 4th chapter, 1 through 13th verse, and the word of God reads, "Therefore I, a prisoner for serving the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of your calling, for you have been called by God. Always be humble and gentle. Be patient with each other, making allowance for each other's faults because of your love. Make every effort to keep yourselves united in the Spirit, binding yourselves together with peace. For there is one body and one Spirit, just as you have been called to one glorious hope for the future. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God and Father, who is over all and in all and living through all. However, he has given each one of us a special gift through the generosity of Christ. That is why the scriptures say, when he ascended to the heights, he led a crowd of captives and gave gifts to his people. Notice that it says, he ascended. This clearly means that Christ also descended to our lowly world. And the same one who descended is the one who ascended higher than all the heavens, so that he might fill the entire universe with himself.
Now these are the gifts Christ gave to the church: the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, and the pastors and teachers. Their responsibility is to equip God's people to do his work and build up the church, the body of Christ. This will continue until we all come to such unity in our faith and knowledge of God's Son that we will be mature in the Lord, measuring up to the full and complete standard of Christ. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers as well as doers of his holy word.
Amen.
To God. I'm reading in your hearing Acts 8, the 26th through the 40th verses. As for Philip, an angel of the Lord said to him, "Go south down the desert road that runs from Jerusalem to Gaza." So he started out, and he met the treasurer of Ethiopia, a eunuch of great authority under the Kandaki, the queen of Ethiopia. The eunuch had gone to Jerusalem to worship, and he was now returning. Seated in his carriage, he was reading aloud from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Holy Spirit said to Philip, "Go over and walk along beside the carriage." Philip ran over and heard the man reading from the prophet Isaiah. Philip asked, "Do you understand what you are reading?" The man replied, "How can I, unless someone instructs me?" And he urged Philip to come up into the carriage and sit with him. The passage of scripture he had been reading was this: "He was led like a sheep to the slaughter, and as a lamb is silent before the shearers, he did not open his mouth. He was humiliated and received no justice. Who can speak of his descendants? For his life was taken from the earth." The eunuch asked Philip, "Tell me, was the prophet talking about himself or someone else?" So beginning with this same scripture, Philip told him the good news about Jesus. As they rode along, they came to some water. And the eunuch said, "Look, there's some water. Why can't I be baptized?" He ordered the carriage to stop, and they went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away. The eunuch never saw him again, but went on his way rejoicing. Meanwhile, Philip found himself farther north at the town of Azotus. He preached the good news there, and in every town along the way until he came to Caesarea. May God bless the hearers and the doers of his word. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
My scripture tonight is coming from the book of Matthew, chapter 9, 35 and 38. And it reads, "Jesus traveled through all the towns and villages of that area, teaching in the synagogues and announcing the good news about the kingdom. And he healed every kind of disease and illness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were confused and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. He said unto his disciples, 'The harvest is great, but the workers are few. So pray to the Lord, who is in charge of the harvest. Ask him to send more workers into his field.'" May the word be a blessing and edification for all of us.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. We're going to call up Deacon McCray and Minister Lewis, just in case you didn't see yourself on the outline of the program. brought our temple you in. Is that okay?
Amen.
So now it's blessing time. Everybody's name is in the blessing, in the seed time. So we want you to be a blessing to these two great women of God. Go into your purse, amen, your wallet, amen, and give your best offering, okay, as they come to our front. As she directs you to come and put your love offering in the basket.
Your creator, your support, your dad, everything you need, amen. Every hour. this thing so bad, I got to lose my mind. And you know,
yeah.
And some tears shed, there will be a minute that you will be by yourself. But don't you let that move you, because I've got a plan for you. I'm taking you somewhere. I'm calling something to happen in the atmosphere. I didn't just call you just to sit around the stove.
But the thing was, when Ananias did
street, but God knew there was somebody in the rain that needed a deliverer. God knew there was somebody in Rome. You know me. We want to go to the lake. We want to stay among all our peers. We want to stay among all the fine clothes and all the fine wine. But I
truly called by God and the church to the life and work of an apostle in the name of Jesus Christ.
I do.
The Apostle Paul testified, "It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Will you endeavor to be diligent in your practice of the Christian apostle and lifestyle, reading the Bible and seeking God for directions on how to govern his people, continually, steadfastly in prayer, and taking up your cross daily to follow Christ?"
I will, with the help of God.
Scripture teaches that the church was devoted to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. Will you endeavor faithfully to fulfill your calling among the people committed to your care by the preaching of the Word of God and the apostolic faith, and by presiding at the celebration of the baptism and the Lord's Supper?
I will, by the help of God.
In Scripture, ministers are exhorted to tend the flock of God committed to their care, not by constraint but willingly, not for selfish gain but eagerly, not by domineering over those in their charge, but by example. Will you endeavor to care for the people of God, nourishing, teaching, and encouraging them, giving direction to the life of the congregation, counseling the troubled, declaring God's forgiveness of sin, and proclaiming victory over death to God's people everywhere?
I will, with the help of God.
The Spirit of God led Jesus to preach good news to the poor, proclaiming release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, setting at liberty the oppressed, and proclaiming the time of God's favor. Will you endeavor to lead the people of God in their obedience to the global mission of the church, guiding their concern for justice, peace, and freedom for all people, and taking a responsible place in the governance of the church and in the service of the world, to the world?
I will, with the help of God.
The Apostle Paul proclaims the church to be one body with many members. Will you endeavor to live and work in unity with all Christians, witnessing to the visible unity of the church, cooperating with disciples, colleagues in the ministry of the congregational, regional, general, and the ministers of the living God as deemed by God and the Holy Spirit, fulfilling the ministry of reconciliation?
I will, with the help of God.
Paul also wrote, "For me to live is Christ." Will you endeavor to conduct yourself so that your life is shaped by Christ Jesus, who took the form of a servant for our sake? And will you, with the help of the Holy Spirit, continually rekindle the gift of God in you to make known to all people the gospel of the grace of God?
I will, with the help of God.
May God, who has given you the will to do these things, give you grace to perform them as an appointed apostle to his people. Apostle-elect Priscilla McCray and apostle-elect Lavaughn Lewis. The people's response. You have heard the promises of our sisters. Will you, as members of God's church, affirm this call and accept apostle-elect Priscilla McCray and apostle-elect Lavaughn Lewis as anointed apostles?
Apostle-elect Priscilla McCray and apostle-elect Lavaughn Lewis, we accept you as ones who are called by God in leadership watch over us and the government authority from said apostleship and the building of the body of Christ. We do place our love and obedience and offer our prayers that together we may glorify our God and make Christ known in the world.
The affirmation of faith. Together, let us renew our covenant to Christ, all people.
We confess that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, and proclaim him Lord and Savior of all the world. In Christ's name and by his grace, we accept our mission of witness and service to all people. We rejoice in God, maker of heaven and earth, and in the covenant of love, which binds us to God and one another. Through baptism into Christ, we enter into newness of life and are made one with the whole people. In the communion of the Holy Spirit, we are joined together in discipleship and in obedience to Christ.
Fresh Oil by Sister Deborah Graham.
Thank you.
watch your lips come and kneel.
Rejoice in God, and you may be clothed in the garments of salvation and covered with the robe of integrity.
Yes.
Deity.
Jesus Christ, the open door to God the Father.
Thank you.
Spirit of the living God, give them insight. Spirit of for the nations. For the nations. For the nations of the ocean. Hold it just a minute. I hear, after this, there's a call. A call away. He's calling away. Somebody, oh, shall come away. Somebody, come away. Who shall I? You go over. Come away. I'm doing all those things. Shall I go by, son? There are some things I want to impart in these things. Come away, who shall I? Come away, who the Lord shall I? Come away, who my son? But this way, this way, this walk shall be a different walk, who my son? A different one, who my son? You shall see me move in ways that I've never moved before. Shall I not shall die? Hey, no, my son, come away. Come away, come away. Shall I be, come away. And I shall show you great and mighty things. Come on and give God a praise. After your sabbatical, your ministry will never be the same again. It will never be the same again. You will never minister the way that you ministered before. There's a deeper, somebody else. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah. Receive your anointed apostles. traditional participating.
Thank you. contain the atmosphere, contain the atmosphere.
That you will continue to encourage us in the things of God,
and you'll continue to guide us on this journey. For I do know that it is a learning process, and I recognize it is a hard journey. But I ask that you continue to be there as a leading post, that I dare not fall. Amen. My spiritual parents, you know who you are. I ask that you stand to your feet.
Giving your all and giving it with full love, without restraint, love you so much. Glory be to God. And to our entire vestry that did not come by chance. Amen.
Amen.
This thing was so prophetic. So we end up with two bishops, Eugene, and two bishops, James.
Connection.
but we always take care of Bishop McLeod. Amen?
Amen.
We don't muscle out there often.
Amen.
And last but not least, to all of you to hold this empowerment ministry, stand up, come on today. Giving me wisdom, words of knowledge, words of understanding, whipping me when I needed to.
Yeah.
One of the greatest whoopings my mom could ever have given me is, you ain't going to church. I love the church, amen. And I know she wouldn't do that, but they became a part of our ministry, amen.
Yeah.
And I'm so grateful. I didn't have to pull and beg them, they just say, we coming over. And there they were, bringing their supply. And before that, my prophetess Marshall Davis. And you were talking to us back then. We kind of came out the same self also. But the Lord strategically put us together. This woman of God, if you knew her 4 years ago, you don't know her now. Amen. I'm grateful to have her as my assistant. Amen. That is a part of our ministry, and I've never seen my relationship with my sisters as better as it is today. So much respect. I never got one word of murmuring and complaining from them. It was because of you I'm here today. Glory be to God. And the Lord that bring that anointing today, oh my God. That's our new praise team leader. The name of our praise team. Garments of praise.
Yeah.
My Lord, look at God. Sister in the back, one of our ushers, Sister Black, and all of you, my brother and other members, and all of our brothers, to come out and sup with us. And you know, I wouldn't have met this woman of God, Pastor Delva, and Bishop Delva, stand to your feet. I met them. Water. IBC, glory be to God. us in your prayer. We're taking wholeness to the nation, amen. We'll be establishing churches as God sees fit, wholeness and prayer to the nations, amen. Be in prayer with us as we embark upon this grand work that the Lord has called us to, amen. Without any further ado, we'll have our chief apostle to come and dismiss us, Pastor. Chief apostle, Earnestine. Come for it, amen.
Thank you. Praise the Lord.
open them now.
I call her my sister, but she's like a mom, even though I'm a little bit older than her age and stuff, but she's like a mama to me, and I just appreciate her so much. She can scold me and we get bounced back, but I just love your spirit, Apostle. And I remember I called you Apostle a while ago, and I said, oh, okay, but to God be the glory. That's from my husband and I, Pastor Neville. We just, come on, sweetheart, I want to see my baby. Y'all don't always see my baby. Most of the time, y'all just see me, but there is a baby. What I was trying to do last night and today, so I was just thinking about you. I want you to know I love you. Choosing me. Amen. You could have chosen anybody, but you chose me. And I thank you. And I don't mind passing the mantle. I've learned a lot from you too. The connection that God brought you, because of you, I met all these other people. Amen. God sent you to me. And I learned a lot from these two. From the internet to things to do on the computer. They have taught me a lot because, I mean, I work on a computer every day, but I don't go into the other stuff that, you know, that they do. But they're teaching me something. I have blog talk radio now. I'm like, whoa, look at me. Thank you. Amen. What you say? Don't mess with me. Amen. But I bless God for them. Amen. And I'm excited. They give me excitement. They add vigor to me. And they give me, they make me want to go. And I thank God for them, amen, for their joy and for their stamina. This is the year, I'm telling you, you know her story, amen. You can't help but be joyous, rejoicing, and what they call inspired to go on, amen. And so I bless God for all of these magnificent men and women of God of the Presbytery, amen. I thank God for you, amen. But most of all, I thank God for the best. I call it my rose, my cultivator, because he called me his rose bush. He takes real good care of me. Amen. God bless you. Amen. We love you. Enjoy the Holy Spirit in all of you. Amen. Because of Jesus in you. And the Jesus in me connected today. Amen. Enjoyed it. Amen. I thank God. Amen. We're going to stand. Amen. And Apostle Rush is going to dismiss us. Amen. And all hearts and minds are clear. Amen. God bless you, Apostle Rush, for final words.
God bless you. Don't worry. I'm not going to be here long. I want to say this to Pastor Lewis. Know that you're in my heart always. There's not a time that I talk to Pastor God. I don't think I'm here. But I told you, I got you. I got you. That woman of God, all I can say is so proud of you. I'm grateful to God that He allowed me to be the door that He does when He does. And Jim, both of you continue to love that country. I'm grateful for your husbands and everyone. Love all of you.
Y'all know who she is.